Thank you so much. Okay. My name is Francesco, already Francesco Ceglie of Siam Bari. So want just to present my organization for 2 minutes and then a little bit of background on the organic greenhouse, maybe some information about Italy, which can be interested to introduction after we go to the seminar. This is Siam. Siam is an intergovernmental organization that has 13 member countries. And actually also Yugoslavia, former Yugoslavia Republic, was a member country, and now all the other countries are applying to be part of the Siam. And so it's an intergovernmental network with four technical seats that are in Spain, in France, in, this is Saragossa, Montpellier, Cagna, in Greece, and this is Bari, in Italy, where I'm working. And the headquarters is in Paris, in France, okay. And each institute has different research topic and interest. This is our SIAM agenda for 2025, a mission with four pillars: protect the planet, food security, nutrition, inclusive development, crisis and resilience. And each pillar has different topics. So we believe to combat triple waste, so knowledge waste also we consider waste, and boosting sustainable agriculture and food with Mediterranean diet, agroecology, food safety, quality, access to food, and also with inclusive development for youth, for rural and coastal development, not only for agriculture, also the coastal area, and gender equality. And these are, and also for migration, climate change, and animal and plant health. These are our tools. So education, training, research, and network. And the approach is to develop these tools is a multilateral approach, bottom up. These are our agenda, and we are working to implement it in 2025. For Siam Bari, so my place is some numbers, I mean, just to give you an idea of last year. We have training, so we have a master student, master in organic agriculture, in integrated pest management, in the water and land management. And so we have master students from the countries that come in Bari for 1 year of a course, and after they, most of them remain, the best one remain for the second year for a master thesis. Also we have cooperation with the university and the research institute for PhD. So we make also short courses, of course, research project. And it's taking place in the last year, the international cooperation activities. We have 45 projects ongoing, mainly are in Mediterranean countries. We did also something quite far, like Myanmar, no? Or now in Sub-Saharan Africa. So this is the topics, this one in the center. Very short presentation for Siam, but if you have any question, please. This is in the experimental facilities of Siam Bari. We develop a greenhouse, a tunnel, and in the picture you can see only one. Now actually are two because we improve it. And so this is in the area of the organic farming, and we decided to study and to try also this interesting subsector of the organic. So maybe why, let me say something, background that also I've developed together with other colleagues in Siam, in Siam Bali, this field of investigation. My idea, I like so much this paper of Foley that presents this situation, this actual situation, very unbalanced from the food production and distribution, the resilience of food system in respect to the impact, I mean. Let me say, no? And he is thinking, is suggesting a way to balance, no, to shrink the impact for the environment and to reach this circle area is the minimum goals. Okay, it's theoretically approach, but gives the idea in the framework where we are working, I mean, no? So, thinking at the greenhouse, this is interesting because it's a way to intensify the production. So when we put together greenhouses and organic, the idea it can be to have an intensification of the production in an ecological way, in an organic way that should be one of the tools that can, one of the practices that can help to reach this. And this is another paper I like so much. To explain in some way this this ecological intensification, no, we can imagine here the global food needs, okay, and the impact for the agriculture of the agriculture on the environment, and theoretically this is the target, no. The idea is that it's possible to produce or to enough food for the world, but the problem is in which way. So the conventional concept of intensification move in this direction, so to improve the yield without taking care about the environment. So already we, in this case, we remain outside the safe space. Our goals is to go in this direction, I mean, to increase the production or at least to decrease the impact of the environment in order to obtain the goals. These are something, some ideas, no, that were in mind. So organic greenhouse, as I told you, is interesting for this reason. But the situation is it's another, because organic greenhouse farmers, yes, intensify the production without taking care to the environmental impact, I mean. So now it's very important, in my opinion, to support organic greenhouse farmers in a way that can help them to reduce the environmental impact, keeping the intensive production, the intensification of the production, okay? So the crop rotation is simplified in the greenhouse. Basically, we speak about vegetables, no? So of course, we have constraints to create appropriate crop sequence and to keep a good rotation. And they move, farmers or greenhouse move towards monoculture, okay? And the requirement of nutrients of the vegetables is satisfied by easy available, easy soluble fertilizer, okay, are organic fertilizers, organic mineral fertilizers we can use, but are easy soluble. So it's something that is like happen in a conventional farm. So this is the background also that was discussed during our project on biogreenhouse, a cost action, this network of European researchers, and the regulation in EU for organic farming do not consider a greenhouse as a separate sector, so there are no specific rules. And of course, we need to follow the same rules in the greenhouse of the open field. This is the actual situation. And also we have outside green organic worlds, we have some farmers of some kind of production, some system of production that claims to be more sustainable than organic. Also some soilless system and also in the greenhouse, they can claims that the use of the water is very well managed, the use of the nutrient is well defined, fine-tuned according to the crop needs, but it's not organic, and but because they use mineral nutrients, but they the message they put a product on the market telling that are more sustainable than the organic that is just certified or not. So, of course, and even in the organic world, we consider greenhouse something that is not possible to be considered organic because it's like a crop produced in a laboratory in a protected environment. So I would like to give you some numbers. This is the situation of the at the time of construction according to the different countries. Basically, this is the hectares of organic greenhouse surface. So Italy and Spain are quite strong. But also I've seen the PhD of Lucia. We have to include something here in UK because she reached the farmers. It's very difficult because the national authorities did not collect statistics about organic greenhouse. So it's very hard this. It's important to pay attention about this. I did some estimation according to your thesis. I think that at least 50 hectares are present in UK of organic greenhouse. It's possible to say something like that. And this is usually important things because the global radiation, it's very, it's a tools. I mean, it's a issue of the environment that affect the greenhouse, the possibility to have a greenhouse production without heating, for example, no, in a very good way. And you can see this is the area where it's very well development and it's very good solution for farmers to implement the greenhouse. But also, in this is sorry, this the scale is not the same. This is 101, but I was not able to manage. This is for UK 1,100 is like this one. So you can have similar situation like we have in the north of Italy. So it's very possible to produce because north of Italy also we have a lot of greenhouses. But the area for Italy well, very well. Okay, sorry. It's the area of Sicily. Now I will show you something. And the situation in Italy is that we have an additional national provision to the EU regulation. This is decree, Article 3, this is the Italian text of the law. It means that crop rotation and green manure are compulsory, that each 2 years you need to, so you cannot repeat the same crop before introduce 2 years of the two cycle of different crops. One of these two should be a legume, not for food, so it should be like cover crop or green manure or something. And this is good, I mean, for open field, the organic farmers in Italy has no problem for this, but in greenhouse, they, as you say, they complain so much because it means that for 70 days per year, you don't have to produce from your greenhouse. You have to cultivate for the soil, for, okay, so they really they were not happy about this. This is the area, just some pictures to explain you what we are talking about. The area of Sicily where it's very used, very common, the greenhouse as you can see. And also we have here a lot of organic greenhouse like this. And in Campania region also, We have a Piana del Sele that is very, very rich in the greenhouse, and most of them are organic. This is an example. And the other region is Lazio region, the region of Rome, and my region here, Puglia. These are some examples. But in that other areas are a little bit spread, not concentrated like Sicily and Campania. So we come back to now to our experiment. This is a little bit the background about this is what's happened in the organic world. So my idea before saying this is that I think there is okay. I would like to show this. The organic world is growing. Okay, according to the surface, the number of growers, of farmers, the market is growing so much in the last year, and the trend very interesting. And we have a lot of certification, all the countries, I mean, not only in Europe. So what's happened is that we have a lot of possibility to implement organic and to reach the target of the certification, implementing very different practices in the field, no? And it comes to me, to my mind, this research of Daronofer, which make the hypothesis of the conventionalization. So he studied that the organic farming, the organic sector is moving towards conventional agriculture. So it may be for the number that are increasing, the value is increasing. So there are different models of organic farming that respect more biodynamic, more bioorganic, let me say, or conventionalized. So the organic certification may be obtained in all these cases. And I think now that organic world is big, is wide enough to investigate what's happened inside the same world, because in the last years we read a lot of papers about comparison organic conventional. But what's happened if we compare organic and organic? Okay. And so this is one idea at the basis of the research. So we consider to implement in organic greenhouse different fertility management strategy in order to consider something like the conventionalization. So it means to base the soil fertility management on the input available on the market. I mean, so fertilizers that are easy soluble, commercial fertilizers. While we compare this approach with another approach that, just to be clear, we call agroecological approach for organic, both of them are organic, but to see what's happening if we stress much more the principles of organic farming, including cover crops, organic amendments, and only at the end the commercial fertilizers, okay? Organic, commercial organic fertilizers. So here we want to stress the on-farm input, the use on-farm input, and while the other system are off-farm input. So this is, let me say, the idea for conventional agriculture. You put the chemical fertilizers that go directly to feed the plant. And for organic farming, you can use many solutions to also feed the soil, what we say. So to feed the soil with organic matter, soil nutrients, so we develop microorganisms that mineralize and go to the plant. But we can do in different way with, I mean, green manure, organic amendment, or directly with organic fertilizers. So this approach is a little bit close to the conventional one, even if it's not conventional, okay, and it can be quite good, as we will see. So we have a simplified approach. I mean, so what you apply what your crops need, if you need nitrogen, you have organic fertilizer that mineralizes quickly the nitrogen, and you apply that. And while you have approached it a bit agroecological, let me say that involved the know-how of the farmers, a lot of work around the system. So you apply organic amendment, compost, and you incorporate the cover crops to synchronize the crop needs and the mineralization of the soil. So this is the difference. Approach that is short term and approach that is long term. So we want to build the soil a little bit, and of course we think that this also it's good for the further crop, but this one also think to feed the crop that you are growing. And we plan this crop rotation, this crop sequence, let me say, with the aims to avoid the crop that belong to same botanical family. We follow all this for several years, and we divided the greenhouse into two fields, and we repeat in both the fields the same rotations in sequence. So we start from the tomato, green bean, strawberries, zucchini, and kohlrabi, lamb's lettuce, so solanaceae, legumes, and these are the three systems we will see in details later. These are the three systems. So we consider a conventionalized system like substitution. We call substitution because you substitute just the input that are included in the regulation with the input that you should use for conventional production. And other two systems. This is a little bit more complicated, let me say, to implement, so more complex to implement, so we decide to try with cover crops, cultivation of cover crops, and organic amendments, so like manure and compost. The agroman, you have cover crop and manure, and agrocom, we have cover crop and compost. We say ASC is agroecological service crop, because cover crop in the greenhouse maybe is not the same, no? Concept of cover crop, but we cultivate these crops to improve the services for the agroecosystem and not for the production, for the market. This is another way what's happening. So we have substitution system. This is the summer period. We don't have bare soil, we don't have anything. We cultivate the main crop. And in the other system, we have a different mix of plants that produce. During the cultivation, not for the production, no? That's agroecological service crop during the summer. And different termination, different way to use at the end of the cultivation this mixture, this biomass. And then we produce the same crop for all. This, just to be clear, this is 1 year, so the agroecological crop and the main crop. This is the first year, after the second year, third and fourth year. And this is only for agroecological system. In the conventional system, here there's bare soil, almost for 60, 70 days per year in summer. Okay. And we, based on this, let me say, experimental design of this research, we studied the system. This is not just experimental on single issue. It's a holistic approach, so we study everything of these systems. Okay, the fertility management, of course, use of the water, of course, the yield, also some crop budget, something related to the quality of the product and the soil arthropods, what's happened about everything that we observed. We try to assess the differences or the positive and negative stuff of these three systems. And this is very holistic picture. I mean, it gives the idea that there is a PhD student is reading the water fluxes, is a master student is measuring agronomic parameters, and some group of students just come for a visit to see what was happening there. And this is also a box, I think, for a bee, the bombo box. Okay, well, it was always like that. I mean, okay, I also visit from the school. What is very nice, these are the two tunnels, and we put in between ecological infrastructure, okay, to attract insects, good insects, no? To when we apply some product for pest control, no? For in the greenhouse, you can see the border are open. Easy, you can open maybe the predators can run away, and the product affect only the insect that remain inside. If we apply, of course, product allowed like copper, sulfur, or some. And also the school come to see what we are doing. This is, sorry, it's in Italian, it's a commercial product, the composition of these strips here, and on the other side are 13 or 15 different plants with the aims to cover with flowers of different color all the months of the season. Okay, so they have an effect on the crop inside. This is true, this also affected the conventionalized system because it's also here, but I mean, this is important for the other system. So we, inside, during the summer, this agroecological crop, we decide by ourselves which mixture prepare. And also we change many times according the function, expected function on the soil. So different different seeds, different crop, this different mixture. We try different mixture during these 4 years to see which one is very good. This is examples how they grow in the different system. And this is a picture how it comes. So this is the conventionalized system, the substitution, and these are the other two. Okay, some examples, this is one mix with poace and fabace, so to have biomass and effect on the soil. Another mix only with legumes with fabace. Another mix is only with brassicace. Okay, maybe they have effect on nematodes. Or a mix, this one, all are legumes, but we added the crotalaria that seems to be a legume with the nematocide effect. So we play a little bit around, but at the end these are some interesting results. Just to show you some picture what's happened, so the crop, the different species cooperate between them. They occupy the different ecological niches in soil and above the soil. And different way, I told you, of termination for this cover crop. This is one production of dead mulch. So when we apply the mixture rich in poace, so we produce big biomass, and we use to flat it to have a dead mulch, okay, instead of use the plastic mulching system. Or we, for the green manure, normal way of green manure, or for biofumigation, we incorporate it fresh. Other pictures of the, this is an examples, how much we produce in 60 days, a quantity of biomass, really, really important, I mean. And this is the machine that we did, the roller crimper to flat, to make this, to terminate this kind of biomass. Because for the greenhouses, I mean, was not developed. It exists this for open field, but are very large because it's important the weight during the operation. You don't have to cut the plants. Okay, you have just to destroy, let me say, the cell in order that they not raise up again, but without cutting small pieces, because the idea is that this biomass can stay on the soil for several months, for 2-3 months. I have also a small video if you about this, if you like, I can show you. So you create a layer of above the soil, and after you prepare the bed without a plug. Okay, so you keep the biomass here and you prepare the bed for the transplant next crop. In this case is tomato. We start with tomato. I go a little bit quickly, but stop me if anything. This is what's happened. This is a conventional system, and this system of Agroman, where we tested also this way to terminate the crop. And this is the Agrocom. We put also soil TDR probes to measure the water moisture at different level, different depth of the soil. So at soil surface, at root level and behind. And we put these ceramic cups to take water circulation solution to see the effect on the leaching, on the drainage, I mean, distribution for the nutrient. This is not my field, but yes, this is a PhD of a student from Eritrea that joined us for more than 3 years. This is the way where which we put. And there is another one also here, already covered. And you see, in this way, you can give the exact, the right amount of water that has been consumed. Okay. So in this way, you reduce, okay, you can measure what's happening, and you can reduce the fluxes of the water. And close to the probes, we put also this to collect the water soil solution and to see the nitrate. So this is, for example, the result for the water. Of course, if we include the water that we applied for the cover crop, this is, of course, this should be considered, okay? Because during the cover crop, the substitution system do not use water. And even if during to produce tomato, the other two systems use less crop, less water than substitution system, already if you consider also the water applied in summer for the cover crop period, the total is higher. We have to work around this, and this is, but this is also is important that even if these tomatoes are covered by the plastic, use more water than the other system, maybe it's the organic matter inside. So this, it's important. So also in the selection of the mix for the cover crop, for the ecological crop, we can found some way to reduce the use of the water during the summer. And this is the drainage also. It was quite good for all. Here we have a little higher the drainage in the agroecological system, and but considering the amount, but it's very low amount. We are liter per square meters during the season. 1 liter per square meter is very few, it's very limited amount. And also the concentration of the nitrate. That so the idea is that these two together gives the lixiviation of nitrate. It's very, very low. So the system to manage the water application was perfect. We had some drainage, but not relevant, I mean. Also, we studied for the tomatoes, the quality of the tomatoes during the at harvest and during the storage, because tomatoes depend when you pick it. This is for tomato, this is the yield, the different systems. One interesting point is that, okay, substitute produce more, but the results were not significant, statistically speaking. So it means some plot produce much more, but some plot not so much. So at the end, we succeed to have acceptable yield in all the systems. And this is also the mineral nitrogen in the soil. Let's go, because I have a lot of slides, but we collect this tomato at others as breakers and pink, most pink, and after we store the breakers to see the difference if you harvest and in store, or if you harvest directly as a pink tomato, to see also this difference, this system of what they which differences they produce in terms of quality, of nutritional quality of the product. Yes, it was a very similar result. What we have is the hydroascorbic acid. It's a part of the vitamin C. Was higher in the substitution system respect to the other dermocom. This was because the mineral nitrogen is also was strange, but was lowest in the substitution system. And this was this result. I mean, so we were satisfied about the yield because we have synchronized all the system and the availability of nutrients for the tomato crop. And what's happened during the storage is that these differences that we have at harvest disappear. So we have some differences, we have recorded some differences at harvest, but during the storage, this happened also for the other crops, these differences disappear. This is for now, we move to green bean, the cultivation of green bean in the greenhouse. And some nice pictures. Production with this are the data of 2 years. We repeat the same crop 2 years because we divide into two fields the greenhouse. So what's happened that in this case the conventional system produces similar or even less than the agro-Romani system. This was quite strange for us. We did not expect, and we found out a lot of nematodes, especially in the substitution system. Here you can see the... And we decided to repeat this in the other tunnel, comparing only two systems, to use half of the tunnel just for this. Okay. So here you can see, this is a conventionalized, this is the other one, this is like the other one we applied. And this new transplant after incorporation, and this is what happened because there is a problem of the nematodes in the soil. This is very interesting. I think this is very, let me say empirical, but was very interesting the result.
results, because after we see this is after the cultivation of cover of crop mix of cover crop in summer, and this is without. I mean, this would be an interesting effect that should be better investigated. Okay, after also we come to the strawberries. For strawberries, we use plastic for all the system with plastic. I'm sorry. Yeah, this is nice pictures. And this is the production was the same. All the system producer, I think mainly because it's 6-8 months of the crop cycle, so maybe also the other system agriculture has more time, has more time to develop. And we studied also the correlation between soil fertility parameter and the quality of the product to see what's happening. So we did it for 2 years. There is a quite new paper about this, and all the parameters we analyzed. This is these are the PCA analysis. These are possible to see, but these are the different plots. 14 is the second year, 15 is the first year, and the again vector are the quality parameters. First we see that all 13 is one side of 14, one side. So I mean the year change affects the data, but also what is that the substitution is very close each other, both the years in the upper part of the just we have just one cases of Agromania, one case of Agrocombra, and in the upper area in positive quadrants, and while all the other are negative. So I think we have to see this parameter that are able to separate the ecological system from the conventional system. And the other Agromania and Agrocombra are quite mixed. I mean. And what we did here is to add the supplementary variables of PC about the soil parameter, in particular the input of the carbon and the nitrogen balance, the nitrogen budget for the that correlate a lot with the agroecological system, with a bit also the nitrogen of the soil, okay, and with the heat, but basically, these are maybe I touch it. What's that? Okay, so the result of this eigenlevel of complexity does not reduce the yield expectation, because more or less the same. And it results with better characteristics of total phenols and of the color, because we have these parameters. And yeah, okay, and the substitution system will define separated clusters that are ecological systems. So also, we did something during the storage of these strawberries. We may be a little bit quickly, but this Agrocom is this seems that the substitution system has a lower respiration rate during the storage than the other two. This should be more in depth analyzed. And it's also a very nice panel test. Okay, I mean, this is the appearance of flower core. Okay, this will be the panel test of this. And during the storage, 0 harvesting, 3 days, 6 days, and 13 days of cold storage. And 13 days, you see substitution is below the acceptability threshold, especially for the development of flowers. We at the end of this 2 years, we calculate also a little bit the gross margin, analyze also, this is another paper, a little bit. It's not my field, but I understood the result very important for me, is gross margin, because this effect we had on the green bean was able to balance the in total, at the end, the total was the same total gross margin in the three systems was not significant difference. So it means that even if agroman farmers have a low gross margin for tomato, they recover when we apply for the green bean. It's very interesting, I think, because seems more resilient. It seems more resilient solution to have these practices. At the end, all the systems are good. Let me say this also is an important question. Also, I did also something about the to use the methodology to classify the different systems. Maybe I can go quickly about this, if we are going a little bit further, but we include close to our conventional production system, and we copy the same strawberries, the same variety, and we purchase from the same nursery, because almost it's that one, and we make them also a conventional production of strawberries, and we include in the comparison, and with the NIR methodology, so the analysis of the spectra, we was able to predict the pH degree, the pH, and the acidity of the strawberries. But the interesting things was that we also succeeded in discriminate the different class of the strawberries. So this the agroman, this is the substitution, and this is the conventional. And we were able with this non-destructive technique to verify if the strawberries come from organic field or not. And this was very interesting, and it's, I think it's will be very important to try to other crops, other soil solutions, soil condition, other practices. If this is confirmed, it can be very, very interesting, and we can also be support for the inspection body for this. Okay, then we move to the kohlrabi. I put it because very interesting that we don't use the kohlrabi in our diet, I mean, very few. But we produce, especially in Puglia, for the German market, yeah? And they want this cytoplasmatic male, this GMS-free. So they're not only, so the variety should be CMS-free, so I understood a lot of them. But this says something like they want to be sure that not manipulation, length manipulation is being applied for the varieties before you plant and transplant. But it's very good crop this for us, because in I think in 50 days you have a very good production, and it's very nice this forest varieties. And also this substitution is very short cycle crop substitution, produce a lot, and that's it. After the kohlrabi, we plant the lettuce, and also in this case, substitution produce much more than agrocom, and even more than agroman in absolute value. And going quickly, sorry, after we add the zucchini. I like also just to show you some pictures about the crop that we did, because and this is also substitution produced more about this. Some something is under elaboration, a lot of data. This is lamb's lettuce or corn salad, I don't
know.
And we try this system here with this tissue with the seeds in the tissue, between two layers of this biodegradable tissue. It's a product of a company, an entire company. And so we send them the seeds, and they put as we want in this tissue to see, because to control weeds, because this is one of the, I think, best problem. And was not so good, let me say, was not so good, but the I don't know, it's interesting to try. In this case, maybe for this tissue, we need to apply a lot of water to keep very close to the soil. And I think the substitution, of course, it's affected. So, of course, we use in substitution a lot of AC soluble fertilizer. We lost available nitrogen for substitution, but actually produced much less than the other. And I did also some experiment for the post-harvest and packaging of this. This paper is going to be published about this, and I will show you another time. This is also, I think, very interesting because we started during all this cultivation and the soil arthropods. There is Suzanne, another PhD student. She's from Bosnia and studying at Naples University. And we try to use soil arthropods as a bioindicator in the greenhouse. And at the beginning, we don't know how it can be, how it comes. And this, for example, in one pitfall, we found all of this stuff. she focused on these groups, Calabidi, Staffinidi, Arachnidi, Ophidini, Ireapoli, Sopoli, Collengola. She presented in Izmir, oral presentation. She get also prize as a best oral presentation. Why? Again, we try to count. This is just a matter of counting this insect. And also here it comes that we succeed to separate completely from right to left the substitution system with the other two. That basically follow this Ophidionidae and Ireapoidae and Staphylinidae, which are Ireapoidae and Staphylinidae. So, okay, this one are the predators, and these are more involved in the composition, no? So if you separate by functional groups, we have no differences for this category of detritivores and decomposer, but we have some differences about predators and polyphagous substitution is less. Okay, we don't know why, but maybe we have some ideas. So I mean, the nutrient, the composition of the number of insects or the arthropods that we collect for the different systems is the same. But in substitution, the number of predators and polyphagous, if you put all together, are significantly lower. So it seems that something moves. Also, it was very interesting first to find the differences in plots that are a few meters distances one of the others. Strong differences, and this may be. This is the biodiversity of the soil, the arthropods, and the agroecological system is a bit higher than the other one. But I know I'm I'm recorded, but I don't know if this is true, but there is a paper that is also very important about this. And for sure there is also the effect of the ecological infrastructure. This also I like so much. No one believes this, but so the organic matter, the organic carbon of the soil during the experiment increase. And at the beginning where I was the same, and after we had the ecological system significantly, I forget the latest, but okay, then the substitution system, now we don't know if the characteristics of this organic matter, of this organic carbon, but is the top organic carbon is clear, the trend is clear, and also this is very important to know. And so all these results have been included, the Minister of Agriculture and this time funds for the long-term experiment on the different topics, arable, open field, orchard, and for the greenhouse has selected our experimental field in a network of long-term experiments for organic agriculture. And yes, almost is finished. I mean, we did a lot of dissemination also with the also with social network and video, yes, for Expo, the training school of the Costa Action was very nice to have all these participants all together from different countries, and a lot of activities, and also to thanks you, to thanks all the Perso Fabio, Titanelli, Giancarlo Mignola, all that support me and work together for this, and all this, the group of post-harvest of Foggia University, CREA. Okay. Yeah, but yeah, it's not, it's the sun behind the tunnel, it's not the light.